really fight it out, because I think it is a little bit about going back to the tribal days when we were all in the institute. That said, it's all in good fun, and I'm hoping that we will make this an entirely enjoyable event like we did last year. One of the great things about last year was that, in fact, there was a Pan IIM team, and the Pan IIM team ended up winning. I can assure you that that was not by design. It just ended up that they were doing that. So I think for all of us, the Pan IIM team was meant to not just let people from the IIMs, you know, once we reach the limit of five, but from people from all the other new IIMs take part. So I, for one, will be backing the Pan IIM team with a little bit of parochialism to IIM Calcutta, which is my alma mater. And let the fun and games begin. And, you know, we have a special kind of video to share at the end of this. But over to you, Rahul, for a good old bout of the, not the Hunger Games, but the Tribal Games.
All right. Thanks, Suresh. So welcome, guys, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the second annual Pan IIM Quiz, what I like to call the King of the Quizzes and the Quiz for the Kings. I'm just taking a pause so you can finish your applause for us. So my name is Rahul, and this evening I'll be taking you through the quiz, the 8 rounds of questions tonight. With me, we have Rajiv Rai, who is a legend in the quizzing circles. And for this quiz specifically, Rajiv has set quite a few of questions and even turned up, you know, with having shaved his legs. There's a legend about Rai, old limerick, which is very legendary in the quizzing circles. It goes something like this. I know this well because I just made it up 5 minutes back. There was a legend called Rajiv Rai. He knew the where, the when, and the why. Such is his zing. If he steps into the ring, the mortals need not apply. And so with us, with that zing, Rajiv will be in here as my co-host. And supporting us will be Anand, who will be playing Father Time to this mother of all quizzes. All right. So before we start the evening, before we start the rounds, here are a few rounds, a few rules for the benefit of the audience as well as the important participants. The 8 rounds, each question has 5 rounds. That's for the 5 teams. Or that is, let's say, for the contestants. But the 6th question in every round is for the audience. So the contestants, please do not answer unless the audience is unable to answer. The first 4 rounds go in ascending order, by which I mean your alphabetical order, A, B, C, L, P. And the final 4 go in the reverse order, P, L, C, B, A. The question goes on infinite bounce basis. For those who are new to this, basically the question sequence continues from where it last stopped and doesn't revert back to the original team to whom it was posed. Contestants get 30 seconds on a direct question. After the question has been asked, I will be saying your time starts now. That's when your clock starts ticking. And 10 seconds on pass, that starts more or less immediately. Buzzer will be sounded when the time is up. If no answer is provided by then, the question moves on. So no filibustering and clarifications after your time is up. Each question carries 10 points. Whether it doesn't matter whether it's direct or it's passed to you. Partial points are pretty much at the quizmaster's discretion. Each team gets 1 joker. A complete correct answer with joker gives you double the points. But if you get it wrong, you get minus 10. So it's minus 10 or plus 20. So you can swing 30 points, can make up for a swing of 30 points during the joker. It needs to be announced verbally before you play it, not after your answer is proven right. And it cannot be played on a past question. So bear in mind, because direct questions, you cannot always predict in an infinite bounds algorithm. So be sure, use your judgment and use your luck wisely. If you refuse to pay or you leave it unused or it stays unused, a minus 10 points penalty will be imposed at the end of the 8th round. And for the audience, please type your answers in the Q&A feature of the Zoom, not the chat feature, because the chat answers are visible to all. You don't want to help your fellow contestants or fellow audience members. So please type your answers in the Q&A feature. We'll be keeping a watch there. And the first one to type a correct answer will win the award, which we'll note down and will be awarded, post the event. All right. So some house rules for the teams. All your mics stay on mute unless it's a direct question. As I said, your hands, all contestants should be visible at all the times, especially your hands as well. And keep your phones off, please. No texting or no even possibility for any sneak Googling. So keep your phones off and hands where I can see them. So,
Rahul.
Rahul,
pass on after a question is answered goes to the next team.
Yes, it follows the sequence which I earlier said, A, B, C, L, P for the first four and the reverse for the last four.
Okay, that's fine. No, if it goes to the next team, then there's a chance that some team never gets a direct, right?
I mean, I guess theoretically that is possible,
and in which case that team also gets a minus 10 at the end of the quiz. It's okay, just luck of the draw.
All right.
So with that, we start with the introduction of the team. So from Ahmedabad, we have the Raju, Farhan, Chatur, and Rancho, the idiots. So team IIM-A, would you like to give a quick introduction of yourself?
Hi, this is Milan from 86 Match.
Go ahead, please.
He's the one from 2007 Match.
Anand, 96 Match.
Anirudh from 98 Match.
Ashish, 98 Match.
All right, that's a very laconic introduction. They're men of action, not of words, obviously. So we move on to the next team. From Bangalore, we have the Young Turks, the Kismat Ke Khiladi, the Fatalist. Team Bangalore, IIM-B, would you like to do a quick introduction of yourself?
Yeah, hi, I'll introduce everybody. I am the person who's not the Young Turk, but yeah, it's me, Dibyo, 2003. We have Anindo, 2000. Sharan is 2013 and Arpit 2012 and Swami at the other end is 2006. Hi, everybody.
Yeah, welcome IIM-B. I think all of you are entering the finals for the first time. So a special extra luck, wishing you extra luck from us, my side as well. And then from the city which gave us the kebabs, the biryanis, the kormas and the BMI of 35, we have the Nawabs. Team IIM-L, would you want to... sorry, IIM-C, I need to come to you because you came. I got your poster the last. So, team IIM-L, and just give a quick introduction of yourself.
Hey guys, hi. This is Varun. I'm from 2005 batch. It's Abhay. He's from the 96 batch. Then we've got Shomik, who is from the 2003 batch. We've got Pramthik, Amit from 95 batch, and Pramthik from 2003 batch.
You can figure out all right for the first time.
All the best, guys. Nawabi cuisine, very imaginatively titled. That is something I cannot say about IIM-C because from them, they had a very creatively titled Put Fight Joker. Okay, I guess they are more the quant sorts, not the creative sorts. But team IIM-C, why don't you give a quick introduction of yourself?
Anu. Ajit Nayak, 30th batch.
Anupam Sahai, 27th.
Ram Shankar, 2004 batch.
All right, team IIM-C, you might want to check your Wi-Fi connection because I lost you there for a while. Hope, I assume it was you and not on my side. So thanks, that was team IIM-C. And last but not the least, we have the Pan IIM team who, despite my three reminders of submitting a poster, didn't submit one. So this is their poster, Team Pan IIM. Would you want to introduce yourself? Team Pan IIM?
Yeah, hi. So
that was not a question. Yeah.
No. So absolutely. So we are actually it's like three members from Ahmedabad, one from Kozhikode and one from Bangalore. Our team member from Bangalore, Gautam, could you introduce yourself from you're logged in remotely?
Sure thing. Hey guys, Gautam from IIM Bangalore. I guess I'm the youngest of the lot here, 2018 graduate. Yeah.
Yeah, hi. So on the other end of the spectrum, we have Niloy,
yes,
92. So Niloy is I am Ahmedabad 92. Nilanshuk is I am Ahmedabad 01. I am Ahmedabad 06. And we have Utkarsh from I am
Kozhikode batch 2014.
All right, Pan IIM, welcome to the quiz finals and wish you all the best as well. So with that introduction of the teams and the rules, we are ready to start the quiz. And it's our participants have already climbed to 75 and still climbing. So here is round one, question one. Let the games begin. Sorry, we are on the low budget Zoom account. So I have to put the begin echo effects manually. All right. So the first round is Asia. Question is to Team IIM-A. It's a direct question. This place that you see, which is marked green on the island of Sumatra, housed British presence from 1685 to 1823. You have to name the place and how it also related to how did it lead to the establishment of modern Singapore? You can get part points on this question, but you have to get at least one of them right. Your time starts.
Remember, you can play the joker on your direct at any time.
Your time's up, Team IIM-A.
All right. It was the capital of the Majapahit kingdom, and it was stopped
with Singapore with the Dutch, so that then the Brits got Singapore and the Dutch got these spice-rich locations.
Question. I will pass the question to Team IIM-B.
I guess that this is where Stamford Raffles was posted. He was the governor of that place or something. And on one of the expeditions from there, he kind of wanted to set up a place and he chose Singapore as the spot. The place...
IIM-C?
This is the original... kingdom of this prince Nilay or whatever who traveled to Singapore and saw the lion and named it Singapura. So this is the original kingdom. I mean, he came from this kingdom in Sumatra.
Okay, Team IIM-L.
So this was the Dutch colony, and the Dutch and the Brits swapped New York, New Amsterdam versus this colony.
Okay, Pan IIM.
Okay, this is the kingdom of the Bugis people, whatever the place where the Bugis pirates lived, and the British were there, and then they had to move to Singapore because of the Dutch taking that over.
No, sorry, I'll have to pass it to the audience. Someone there already typed the right answer. Jyotsna Mishra. You get the right answer. This is indeed... the colony of Benkulen. There's a British post in the mouth of Benkulu River, and Stamford Raffles was the last lieutenant governor of the British Benkulen, ceded it to the Dutch, and founded Singapore and moved his headquarters there. So Team IIM-B, you're close, but I had to be a bit rigid on this one. I can't grant this to you, but
so
hopefully you're better.
Can't they get 5 points for the second half?
Second half is all I was actually, okay, fine. I think let's start on a positive note. So Team IIM-B, 5 points. And the second question is anyway, so right, the second question goes to them, right? Or it goes to IIM-C?
No. Now it will go to IIM-C.
Okay. So IIM-C, the second question is yours. So Qantas will once again start the Sydney-London non-stop route in 2023. It will be when it becomes operational, the world's longest direct flight. The dotted red line, however, that you see on your screen is the original Sydney to London air route, somewhere in the mid-40s or late-40s. Take a look at the route and tell us what was it called. That's half the question. And the second half is due to the Japanese invasion of Singapore in Second World War, the flight had to take a longer route, which took as much as 27 to 33 hours to complete. And people who traveled on these flights received a certificate that you see on your left. Certain parts of that have been redacted. So what was this certificate called? You know, what was the order called? Yeah. What two-word term has been blank?
To show them the larger visuals.
I don't think that this one has it. So your time starts now.
Hi, we're ready?
Team IIM-C, what's your answer?
Yeah, the first one is the kangaroo hop. The route is called kangaroo hop. The second one is setting sun.
I'll pass it on to team IIM, L, Lucknow.
So the first one is kangaroo hop or kangaroo hopper, and the second is two sons, the secret of the two sons.
Okay, I think I will, okay. I will grant it to you. It's indeed the order. This, oh, sorry, it was a larger route, right? You're right. This is the secret order of the double sunrise. And the first one is kangaroo route. So I'll give partial points to IIM-C and partly to IIM-L. So 5 and 5. During the Japanese invasion, they had to route their air flights to Galle in Sri Lanka. And it was Perth to Galle and Galle to London, taking a total flying time even then of 31 hours.
Rahul, how is two suns the same as double sunrise?
No, they did say subsequently double sun, two sunrises. So I think I was looking for the word of two sunrises, a double sunrise. So 5 to IIM-C and 5 to IIM-L. So the next question.
Pan IIM.
So in the Bahasa language of which is used in Malaysia and Indonesia, what word is actually used for west and east, signifying the directions from, you know, merchants from particular country came to Southeast Asia? And B, that is the east, also gives its name to a country. So I'm basically looking for two answers again. The words for west and east, and how do they map to the countries? Your time starts now. Pan IIM, you have an answer ready? If not, I will pass it.
Okay. One second. Just a second. Timor for east. Just a second for west. One second. We're just discussing.
I'm sorry. You have 30 seconds. I have to pass it.
Okay. Yes. Timor is east.
IIM-A.
Timor is east.
Okay. IIM-A, question passes to you.
The country is Timor-Leste. So the country's name is also Timor-Leste.
You're on mute.
No, I heard, Pan IIM, I heard you. I heard the country also.
Okay.
IIM-A, 10 seconds for you.
B is Timor for East, and A is Bugis for the Arabs.
Question passes to IIM Bangalore.
Is West is India and East is Timor.
So what are you saying, the Bahasa word for West? That's the...
In Hindi.
I'm Calcutta.
Direction is Hindu and the country is the modest. West means India.
Sorry, is it us?
It's yours.
So it's Timor and India. So,
That's what IIM-B also answered. So, Hindu, I have to pass it Hindu, to
Hindustan.
IIM Lucknow.
Hindu and Timor.
Yeah.
No, I think so. Wheel comes full circle. Let me check in the audience. Audience, the question is up to you. Yes, I think Arun. No, sorry, TG. TG has answered it correctly. It's indeed Bharat for West and Timur for East. So Pan IIM, I'll give you 5 points. You got the East part right. I was looking for Bharat, so India doesn't really help in that sense.
It's a word in a language. You can't give a, you have to tell me.
Yeah, I mean, so, you know, several words like the word, Malay word for North is also Uttara, but kind of, I'm assuming long, older trade linkages kind of must have helped. All right, so next question now is to, that was for Pan IIM. So next question is to IIM-A, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So IIM-A, this is your direct question. Which town, which saw remarkable recovery from the impact of the 2004 tsunami, including lots of rebuilding, new airport, port, and cricket stadium, it also built for the Commonwealth Games, incidentally, is named for the Chinese sampans that traveled there in ancient times. your time starts now. IIM-A.
Yeah. Is it Gaul in Sri Lanka?
IIM-B.
Is it us?
Yeah.
Yes, IIM-B.
Hambantota.
Hambantota is indeed the answer. It comes from Sampan or Hamban, and Tota means Nagar or Pur. So Hambantota, which is right now again a kind of area of focus for the Chinese. So team IIM Bangalore, 10 points for you. Next question goes to IIM Calcutta. This one's a direct for you. So, descendant of Sang Nila Uttama, the founder of Singapore, fled north from the Majapahit invaders from, you know, Indonesia northwards and established this place. While resting under a tree, he saw a mouse deer, which is endemic or local to this region, outfitting a hunting dog in the river. Impressed by this, he founded the new city there and established his new kingdom. Name the city. So this is also, again, partial points are possible. Name the city and also say how is this incident commemorated in that city. Your time starts now. And Calcutta.
The Soviet Malacca. Yeah, the city is Malacca. The place is Malacca, and the incident is commemorated in the boat races. In the boat races in Malacca.
I am Lucknow. Question passes to you.
The city is Bandung, and it's commemorated through a festival where they burst firecrackers.
Pan IIM, question passes to you.
Unmuted. City is Palakansar. I have no idea what the festival is.
Okay. IIM-A, question passes to you.
Okay, the city is Penang. And the event is
swimming race.
Okay, now we're getting creative. Team IIM Bangalore, I think you're the last in the sequence that comes to you. IIM Bangalore.
I think the city is Kuala Lumpur, and this is where the name Petaling Jaya comes from, which is part of Kuala Lumpur.
Let me pass the question to the audience.
Why?
Quiz. All right. So, team, no one from the audience has also got it right. So, maybe this question was a bit tough, but still, IIM-C, I'll give you partial points to you. The city is indeed Malacca. And the incident was commemorated by the mouse deer, which is on the coat of arms, and the tree under which it was done is called Pokok Malacca. So, city gets its name from the tree. So, IIM-C, you get 5 points for this round. Well done. The descendant, incidentally, was Parameshwara. And that's one theory at least. He was later on called Iskandar Shah. And he was basically the one who embraced Islam and started the Islamization of the country. So the descendant was a bit, you know, a pretty noteworthy individual in the history of that country. So that finishes round one, direct questions. So Rai, why do you tabulate the scores? I have the scores.
So at this stage, IIM Bangalore is in lead with 15 points. They answered 2 questions. Calcutta is at 10, Lucknow on 5, Pan IIM on 5 as well. And Ahmedabad is not yet troubled me. So,
okay. So, fine. Then it's too early to call. I think it's to call, you know, who's the clear leader. So, buck up team IIM-A and, you know, Pan IIM. Next question is for the audience. So, please, teams, put yourself on mute. This is only for the audience. So audience, this question is to you. Again, please, those who came in late, please type your answers in the Q&A feature, not in the chat, because the chats are visible to everyone. So this question goes to you. The story of King Kong was inspired by the adventures of a descendant of Cornelius Vanderbilt, an airman or pilot. He landed on this rugged volcanic island in 1912 and brought back fantastic stories and of monsters, dragons, you know, breathing fire, eating goats, chasing horses, even going after ladies, young ladies in distress. Which was the island that he landed on? Audience, your time starts now. So far, okay, it was quite fast. I have to give it to Amit. I don't have a full name. It was indeed the island of Komodo. And there was a clue in there, you know, chasing damsels in distress. So the story of King Kong was supposedly inspired by the legend of Komodo. And you see our fellow quizmaster there in the background, not the dragon, the one behind him. All right, so that finishes round one. And we are on to round two, which is business, something hopefully close to all the members of the, all the team members, as well as the audience. I forgot, when did we end round one?
Okay, so the last question was partially answered by IIM-C. So this will go to L.
L. So I am Lucknow. This is your direct question. This logo of an erstwhile iconic company was essentially a stylization of the first letter of the name, first letter of the company's name. However, the designer, George Opperman, claims that he drew inspiration from the flagship product of the company. So the company obviously was known for a product. So the product was reflected in the logo. However, over the time, the logo acquired an affectionate nickname due to its resemblance to the mountain. I'll show you in the next picture. The basic question, the answer which I'm looking for is, which company are we talking about? I am Lucknow. This is your time starts now.
Please, can you show the question again, please?
Go back to the question.
I just need the name of the company, so not the theory about what it was, what was the product, or what it's meant to signify. Basically, just a simple answer. Which company are we talking about?
That was the mountain logo. That the mountain is just a, like a placeholder picture, or what?
No, the resemblance to the mountain. The logo acquired an affectionate nickname due to resemblance to the mountain, and that was the mountain which I showed.
Rahul, we have a small issue.
Yeah.
I think the Pan IIM participant who is from India, I think he messaged me saying that he's able to see the Q&A answers being posted. Is that correct?
Oh. The panelists. So, okay, one request to the audience members, don't type in answers before I open. So, please, thanks a lot for pointing it out. So, audience request is, don't type the answers before the open to the audience, because the panelists can, other audience members can't see your answers, but the panelists can see your answers. So, inadvertently, you might be, you know, helping them out. So, don't open the, don't type in any answers until I open it to you. So, sorry, team IML, your time should be up. What's your answer?
Let's go back to the text.
Hey, sorry, I think the answer is there.
Guys, the answer, somebody has already typed it in.
Oh. I guess you'll have to skip this one.
Guys, please, I mean, I appreciate your enthusiasm, but please avoid this. We have to obviously scrap this question and move on to the next one. I think we'll have to work in. So, the audience question for this round, I will not open to the audience. I will use it for the, you know, main teams. So, but please don't type in any questions. So I don't know, Anand, whether you can, any way of, you know, opening the Q&A only at certain times and otherwise shutting it down. So, but yeah. So
I think we need to block this. I think we need to block the Q&A.
Yeah, we should block.
So Deepika, if I can figure out how to block the Q&A until, you know, we open it, I think find a host.
Just make me the host. I'll do that.
Okay. I'm just wait a minute. What name have you logged in under the big?
Pan
I can't
IIM,
see.
Pan IIM. Pan IIM.
Oh, Pan IIM. Okay, fine. I'll make it co-host, so I don't have to, you know, kind of, all right. I made it host. So see if you can log the Q&A. Fine, since the answer is typed, I'll kind of...
You can give it as an audience prize to whoever answered this first. It's not their fault that, you know, the other saw it.
Fair enough. I think that's not a bad way. So we just, I think it's answered by Tarun Nallu Atari. That is indeed the answer I was looking for. So Atari, the logo was essentially a stylized A representing two people across the net, a tribute to the game Pong, which was basically bought them success. But people thought it was represented Mount Fuji because Atari made it sound Japanese and affectionately called it Fuji. So I'm Lucknow. You're still, let's say, the second question still comes to you. So scratch this question out. And Deepika, hopefully, an audience, in case Q&A is not shut down, please don't type your answers until we open the questions for you. Okay, question IIM-L, this is your direct question. After it split from the parent company, the company was renamed through an internal company contest. Kim Peterson, one of the employees from the Norwegian office, won the contest to come up with this innovative new name. On Jan 1, 2001, at the turn of the millennium, the company officially changed its name, a very wise decision considering what even happened just a year later. What was the name of this company? I am Lucknow, your time starts now.
In the visual, the guy on the right is the guy who proposed the new name. He's being given a reward for that. That's all.
Okay.
I am Lucknow. It's I am Lucknow.
Yeah, we're going to play a joker on this.
Okay.
And the answer is Accenture for the new name.
Bravo. Brilliant. So I think in a way, it worked very well. The Atari question was accidentally leaked. Yeah, it's indeed Accenture from Accent on the Future. So I am Lucknow, you get 20 points for this question. Well done. Next question goes to Pan IIM. And your question is this. In 2017, with the release of iOS 11, the Apple Maps icon changed from, you know, from the left to the right. So what was the reason for this change? What prompted it? So I'm looking for a certain event which prompted this change of the logo. Pan IIM, this is your time.
So basically,
this is our direct.
Yeah, so this is our direct. We take the joker. So basically, in 2017, Apple moved their headquarters. 280 is the highway in California. So they were on one side, they moved to the other side. Where
basically, they bought the HP.
I'll grant it to you. Stop sweating. I'll grant it to you. That indeed is the answer. The icon, since its inception, had shown, you know, its infinite loop, the original long-time headquarters. So in 2017, they changed it to the new spaceship campus to see on the right. And that's what the location is. So the, and I honestly, I didn't know it either. So I had to, I was the one who actually came up with this question. So it's a small bit of interesting trivia that otherwise I wouldn't have known. So you get 20 points also, Pan IIM. Well done. So next question goes to Team IMA. Which famous person who was later himself parodied several times in Amul ads, two sisters Shobha and Smita, were the original Amul babies chosen by the ad agency ASP. I think it's stood for advertising. I forgot what it stood for. Shobha was the first baby in the black and white version from 1961. And Smita was the first color baby from 1962. So the answer which I'm specifically looking for, who is the famous person whose sisters were the original Amul babies? Team IMA, your time starts now.
Was it Shashi Tharoor?
Yeah, absolutely. Very well done. There was indeed Shashi Tharoor, and congratulations on opening up the account as well. You get 10 points for Shashi Tharoor. What's that?
We are doing the Ajit Agarkar bat race now.
Very well done. That was indeed Shashi Tharoor. So that was IIM. I think everyone's getting the direct question straight up. So the next question now is
IIM-B.
This is your direct question. So these Transarctic mountains in Antarctica that you see in the background were named actually by Admiral Richard E. Byrd for William Dash of Russia and Wisconsin, who basically was the financier behind the expeditions. Now, what well-known brand name fills up the blank? So this product or the blank was also useful on this exploration as a non-perishable commodity. So team IIM-B, your time starts now.
Okay, we are playing a joker and the answer is Horlicks.
Wow, okay, brilliant. That is indeed Horlicks. I think this is a joke around. It was started by William Horlicks as a malt drink. Subsequently, actually, I think found much bigger success in India, where it's India's largest selling health drink. Although India is sold as a children's drink, in the West, it was sold initially as a drink for the, you know, old people and the invalids. So it was Horlicks drink for the invalids. So that's why the S became a part of the logo and the apostrophe was subsequently dropped. So team IIM-B, well done. That was indeed your direct. So I think three teams played the joker and all of them hit the target. The next question, this is the audience question. So audience, this is not for you. Please do not answer. This question is for team, who was it?
C.
So team Calcutta, your question is Mitchell Baker in a...
Yeah, we also play the
joker. The joker. And it's Mozilla Foundation.
Sorry, see, are you playing your joker as well?
Yeah.
Okay, I think you got the answer even before I finished the question. So that usually indicates you must be right. It is the Mozilla Corporation from Mosaic Killer and, you know, Godzilla. And the lizard in that logo is basically the trip to Mozilla being a killer of the, you know, reference to Godzilla. So team IIM-C, you also get 20 points. So I think that finishes round two. Rai, you want to kind of quickly go through the scores? I think there's quite a bit of change in that round.
This round turned out to be a joker round, actually. First, the audience answered out of turn in a way, and then the teams really killed it. All the questions were answered on the direct without passing, and the only team that did not play the joker was IIM-A. Everybody else got 20 points. In the lead right now is... B with 35, you have C with 30, L and Pan IIM with 25 each, and A has put 10 points on the board. But they have a joker left. They have a joker with them, so
not that far. So A is the only team that has yet to play their joker, right? All others have played their joker.
Yeah, all others. We obviously underestimated the business knowledge of the Singaporeans.
And we are only at the end of round two.
They don't know much about Singapore, but a lot about business is my takeaway from this.
All right. So, well done, teams. I think that was a high scoring round for all. We move on to round three. Round three is history. And the question goes to Lucknow, right?
Yeah, this was answered by C. So, it goes to Lucknow.
Yeah. So, Lucknow, this is your direct question. The logo that you see in the bottom right of the screen signifies a quite a momentous initiative in this country's history. It's widely described as the most intensive peacetime logistics project. So name the country and the initiative. Although it's two answers, I cannot give you answers only for the country. I really need the initiative. So if you just get the country and even the accent, you get it right, I can't give you points. So I really need the initiative.
Yes, the full answer. Points. The full answer gets points, otherwise
not. So Lucknow, your time starts now.
Yeah, so this the country is Sweden, and Sweden decided to move from driving on the left-hand side to driving on the right-hand side of the road, and this was the initiative for that.
Excellent answer. That's indeed the answer. It was called Dagen Etch. Dag means day, and Etch stood for Huger Traffic Kumlingningen. I hope I pronounced that right. That was indeed
Etch is essentially right in Swedish. The right side is Etch.
Okay. So, yeah, indeed, that was the last European country to switch its traffic to the right-hand side of the road to be in line with the, you know, European traffic convention. So, team IIM Lucknow, you get 10 points for that. Well done. Next question goes to
Pan IIM.
This is your direct. So, the Battle of Solferino fought between the, you know, the French, Italian, and Austrian forces was essentially a major battle fought to liberate Italy from the Austrian occupation. It was quite a brutal battle. Amongst other things, it was also the last battle to feature all armies under direct command of the kings instead of the generals. So this single day of battle was the most brutal, killed nearly 5,000 and wounding 25,000, quite a high number for Europe in those days. Witnessing the devastation, a young Swiss Christian who was there undertook two initiatives, which are still pretty much in force, to make war more civilized and sufferings more bearable. I don't need the individual. I need both the initiatives. What both initiatives are talking about? You can get partial points if you get half of them right. So this was for Pan IIM. This is your direct question.
Yeah. Hi. Okay. So the two initiatives are that Medicine Sans Frontiers, or Doctors Without Borders, and Red Cross.
Question passes to IIM-A.
So we think this is the Red Cross and the Geneva Convention.
Okay, I'll give partial points. Pan IIM, you get 5 points, and IIM-A, you get 5 points. This is indeed Andri Duna, who went on to start the International Red Cross and the Foundation for the Geneva Conventions. So, Metzra Sans Frontières, I think, is more French. This was both of these.
Yeah, it was in Africa, much later in the 1960s, it was started in Africa.
So, IIM-A, you got this. So, next it goes to IIM-B. This is your direct. This one is what I would think that it would be easy, but no pressure. So, IIM-B, this is your direct. During the Middle Ages, the Chinese port city of Quanzhou, which was known in Europe as Seitun, saw large shipments of this produce being exported through this the maritime silk road, not over land. So there was great demand in Arab countries and also Europe for its account of its luster, and the product pretty much became synonymous with the port city. So I don't need the port, which is anyway part of the question. What product are we talking about? Team IIM-B, your time starts now.
Satin.
Yep, that is indeed satin, which got its name from Zaytun. So it's that's the produce which was exported from this port. Good answer, Team IIM-B. 10 points. Next question is for IIM-C. This is your direct question. A bit tricky, but all the best. So the two locations which you will see in the next slide, just read out the question, along with five other such similar structures in the vicinity, are collectively responsible for the name of this Indian city. But it was also the center of a princely state that stood for about 30 years till its ruler Shahaji passed away. There's already a clue over there. So what happened for the first time under the then Governor General? I will show you the picture now. So these are two structures of the seven. I need the name of the city and what happened with the Governor General when the ruler passed away. Team IIM-C, your direct question, your time starts now.
Can
you just move the screen back to the original question?
Yeah, can you move back to the original question?
You can use me.
I think
this is the... Time is up.
Doctrine of labs was implemented.
Good. I don't know whether you knew that or you worked it out. It's indeed Satara, the seven structures, that's what it gives its name. Satara and the doctrine of labs by under Lord Dalhousie, under which you could annex a kingdom if the ruler became incompetent or, let's say, incapable. And that was triggered, and Satara was annexed by the British, the then Governor General. Great answer, IIM-C.
Rahul, the doctrine of lapse kicked in when the ruler did not have an issue, proper issue.
They don't have a male heir, right? They have to have
male heir.
Correct. Right. Something, which technically maybe can be applied for Congress party these days as well. All right, the next question goes to
L.
I am Lucknow, so I think, yeah, this one should be a relatively easy one. So this is the last question for the team. The next one goes to audience. So IIM-L, your direct question comes here. So stationed in Jordan, as a brigadier, he helped in the training of the Jordanian soldiers and commanded the Jordanian 2nd Division in battle. He received Jordan's highest honor for services rendered for actually putting down a rebellion and was promoted to chief of staff in his own country in 1976. In 1977, he deposed the leader of his own country and became the president. Who are we talking about? I am Lucknow. Your time starts now.
Ziaul Haq.
Okay, that was even faster than I said. That's indeed Ziaul Haq, who put down the Black September uprising in Jordan, where the PLO started actually calling for the overthrow of the Hashemite kingdom. And he was rewarded for that and basically came back to Pakistan throughout Bhutto and became a president. Good answer, Team IIM-L. So that finishes the team questions. Right, before we go into the audience question, you want to quickly kind of update the scores?
Yeah, it is developing into a battle royal here. IIM-B and IIIM-L both at 45 points. IIIM-C close behind at 40. Pan IIM at 30 and IIM-A with the Joker still in hand at 15.
All right. So, welcome team IIM-A. I had written a lot of jokes, assuming that you would be the lead. I had to throw them all away, which I don't want to. So, all right. So, the audience, this question is for you. Now you can type in Q&A. First come, first serve. Your question starts here. So, Belarus has one of the most repressive regimes in place today in Europe. So, simple question. What is the name of Belarus's secret service? The one that is employed to keep dissidents in check. You can type your answers in the chat. TG. TG has got it right. It is indeed KGB. They never changed the name. So that's indeed KGB. After the fall of the Soviet Union, retained the name. And the building that you see there is the KGB headquarters in Minsk, an imposing structure composed of 70% stone and 30% microphones.
Hey,
all
Rahul,
right.
Rahul,
yeah.
Just one thing I want to interrupt. Audience, guys, if you can type your full name, that would be useful to figure out who answered the question, you know?
Yeah. Thanks, Anand. Yeah, TG doesn't really help much in, you know, finding out who scored. So, fine. So, TG, just type in your full name. The answer you got it first, right? And now that closes round three. And we go to round four. And this is a round after which we can take a short break. We're doing pretty all right for time. So, round four. It's mythology and religion.
Question for Pan IIM.
Question for Pan IIM. Pan IIM, this is your direct question. So, as per Greek mythology, Hera, wife of Zeus, was so jealous of the illegitimate son to a mortal woman of her husband Zeus, Heracles or Hercules, that she sent two snakes to kill him, whom both the baby Hercules duly strangled to death. When Zeus came to know of this incident, he put Hercules, to Hera's breast to suck her on the milk to make him immortal. However, when Hera woke up, she pushed the baby away and thus ending up creating what? Your time starts now, Pan IIM.
Yeah, the object is the moon.
Question passes to IIM-A.
Yeah, it's the Milky Way.
Yeah, indeed, it is the Milky Way. So Hera's milk basically spread across the heavens, forming the Milky Way. And that's how it is known. It was first used in English by Geoffrey Chaucer in his poem and it's kind of become adopted in English as well. And the right resume galaxy also means Milky Circle. I assume that's also the root of, you know, lactic acid or lactose. So great question, IIM-A. Question two goes to IIM-B. Okay, so this is a bit longer question, so bear with me. A father and a son in the aftermath of a devastating war find a queen and a daughter alive and decide to take them home. On due time, the son marries the queen, that is the mother, and the father marries the daughter, the princess. The son and the queen have a son and the father and the princess have a daughter. Now, this mind-bending question naturally arises. What is the exact relation between the two newborn children? Now, that's a good story, slightly incestuous one perhaps. But what is the significance of this story and the question? Your time starts now, Team IIM-B. This is your direct.
The story that the final question that the vampire poses to Vikram and he's unable to answer and then says his thing and then that cycle ends.
Perfect. Very good answer, Team IIM-B. That is indeed the last question in, you know, the Betal Panchvim Sati, which sums the king ending the series. And volunteer, all right, you see Vikram and Betal practicing social distancing, Indian style. All right. So next question goes to Team C. IIM-C. That's right. The next question goes to you. Again, a bit longish. Daughter of Daksha. She was besotted with Agni, the god of fire, who basically ignored her advances. So Agni, later on in a separate event, was so enamored by the wives of Saptarishis while, you know, presiding over their sacrificial rituals, unable to bear the guilt for having weakness or lust for a, you know, married woman, he went to the forest to perform penance. Daksha's daughter followed Agni and took the form of the wives of Saptarishis and spent many loving moments in the forest with him. That's as mildly as I can put it. Agni rewarded her by giving her a boon that she will always be remembered along with him. So I need the name of this daughter. I am Cal. This is your dear question. Your time starts now.
So this is Swaha. And that is why when you do or whatever you put inside Agni.
Correct. Good answer. Team IIM-C is indeed Swaha. The men's are mandatory Swaha when offering oblations to Agni as per Hindu rituals. Daughter Daksha and his wife Prasuti, which is also the word for maternity. They had 60 daughters, so that explains why the term came to mean as maternity. So Team IIM-C, good answer. Next question goes to Team
Lucknow.
I'm looking for a specific word which comes from the wooden statue of Athena that Odysseus and Diomedes stole from the citadel of Troy. Because the safety of Troy was dependent on the statue, and it was only after the statue was stolen, the city fell. And therein lies the clue to the word as well. The statue continued to offer protection to other cities where it was located. It was taken to future city of Rome by Aeneas, where it remained until transferred to Constantinople after it was established, and then basically lost sight after the conversion of the empire to Christianity. So somewhere between 1000 and 1400 AD, the statue was lost. So I'm looking for which word comes from this wooden statue. Team Lucknow, your time starts now.
Okay, we're going to try icon.
Sorry, what? I could you repeat your answer? I couldn't hear it.
Icon. They said icon.
Icon. Okay, a question passes to Pan IIM.
Yeah, is it Bastion?
IIM-A.
It's Talisman.
IIM-B.
Is it Palladium?
Yep, IIM-B, you get it. 10 points. It's indeed palladium. It also gives its name to an element now, but that's indeed palladium is also used to denote an object which kind of grants you protection. But good guess in talisman as well. I think that was guessed by IIM-A, but sorry, this is not the right answer. The next question goes to IIM-C. This is your direct. I think a bit tricky one, but you have cracked them before. You might crack them again. So this pictured bird from Iranian myth, which you see, I mean, it's a statue, obviously, because it's a mythological bird. It never rests and does not land on the ground. It's also found in the emblem of Uzbekistan. So monarch was, I can't give you any more clues. So monarch was named for this bird to ensure he had a long and glorious reign. You know, and ironically, his reign was exactly the opposite. There were historians, Stanley Lane Poole summarized his life as he tumbled through life and he tumbled out of it. There's a clue in it for you as well. Name the bird or the king. So either of them, you get it right, I'll give 10 points. If you get both right, there are no extra marks, but you can try. IIM-C, Calcutta, your time starts now.
We think the king is Simurgh.
Or the bird is Simurgh.
The bird is Simurgh. Sorry, I don't know which is Simurgh.
Cal, the question passes to IIM-L.
Yes.
Go
for it. Cyrus.
Sorry? Cyrus.
Cyrus.
They're saying Cyrus bird. Cyrus bird.
I'm the question Pan-I-M. Passes. So now question passes to Pan IIM.
Humayun.
All right, good answer, Pan IIM. That was Indian
Humayun. Good. Yeah.
Comes of Huma, and I don't know whether he got it from the clue that he tumbled out of it. He fell through down a flight of stairs. So for a long and glorious reign, he was the only Mughal monarch who was actually deposed by Sher Shah Suri, and he would come back after 15 years, aided by the Persians to reclaim back his throne. So it is indeed Humayun. Good answer. I didn't know that myself. This question comes from Rai. Pan IIM, you get 10 points. And I think that was the last question for the teams. The next question is for the audience. So teams can go on mute. Audience, this is your chance. Guru Jambeshwar in the 16th century in Marwar laid down the 29 principles to be followed by his community. So obviously passed away soon thereafter. And but what form is Jambeshwar believed to return to earth? Your time starts now. I am looking at the Q&A. So far, no right answers. In fact, so far, no answers. If I get right or wrong. I got an answer called rats. Someone got Kalki. Okay, I'll have to start my countdown. If not, I'll open it for the teams. So teams don't get any points for it, but you can try. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
Black Buck. Black Buck.
Yeah, okay, you got it. Finally, team has an answer. It's indeed Black Buck. Which is basically what also, you know, got Salman Khan his fame, his version of demonetization to get rid of his black bucks.
So the clue in the question, the clue in the question was the 29 principles, which is how the Bishnois get their name, East and North Bishnois.
Yeah, good side to you, right? So we are kind of exactly the halfway mark, both in terms of time, we're exactly at 6:30, also in terms of rounds. I'll just ask the team if you need a bio break, or we continue uninterrupted.
So no bio break. 2 minute bio break, please.
All right, let's say 2 minute bio break. I'm not going anywhere, so I'm still here. We start exactly in 2 minutes. So really, 2 minutes is 2 minutes, and we reverse the sequence.
Rahul, while we wait for people to join back, has the audience member TG given his name?
Yes,
yes, yes.
It's TG Ramakrishna.
TG, famous as TG. TG Ramakrishna. Everyone knows TG.
So it has been very high standards quiz, rapid answering. And
yeah, I mean, quite a few, I think, direct questions got through.
Yeah.
I think, but Rajiv, at the same time, two questions went through all six teams unanswered as well. So.
Yeah. And Rajiv, you've got to up the standards, I think, next time. Last time, people were wondering a lot more. I think we've all been spotting for this.
I know. I think this lockdown, there has been a lot of online quizzing and a lot of practice for everybody. So.
True. The swords have been too sharp.
Yeah.
All right, teams, try to get back in positions. I think we are almost only 30 seconds left. So those of you guys can still listen to me. Please get your team members and assemble.
I think the IMC team is shaking up some cocktails out there.
I think those are already celebrating the victory.
Rajiv, once the teams come back, can you give this call?
I'm waiting for that.
Oh, sorry. We didn't announce the scores at the end of last round. All right. Okay.
Yeah, we didn't.
Before we start. All right, team Lucknow and team Ahmedabad, if you can get in front of the screens, we are starting now. Hopefully, you can hear me.
Just give us a minute, Rahul. They're just coming in.
Okay.
There is nobody in IIM team to field the question also.
I hope they can hear me though. I hope they're in the room.
I think they're replacing their teams.
borrowing
a few of their alumni from the Pan IIM team.
So team Ahmedabad, okay, great. You are back. Lucknow's back as well. Pan IIM, I can't see you in my limited screen size. Hopefully, you're there as well. Okay.
Pan IIM is there.
One person. Give us a minute.
So, all right, four rounds in, four more to go. Rai, you want to quickly update the scores before we start?
Yeah, so
at the halfway mark, the IIM Bangalore team has taken a slight lead. They are at 65 points. And in second place is IIM Calcutta with 50. Lucknow in third place with 45. Pan IIM at 40. And IIM Ahmedabad is at 25. But I should remind the Ahmedabad team as well that their joker is pending, though they have four more rounds in which to play it.
Rajiv, you're waiting for the check, man. All the directions are conspiring.
So now the questions will come the other way around, and whenever IIMB answers, which they had been doing a lot in the previous round, you will get a direct. So all you need to do after getting the direct is that you need to know the answer and then play your joke.
That's the easy part. All right. So we reverse the sequence, and the first question goes to Pan IIM. So this round is sports. Pan IIM, first question for you. It's a direct. So Saurashtra, you know, won the Ranji Trophy in 2020 after being the runners-up on three occasions in the last decade. Before this, it was way back, almost 8 years back in 36-37. However, they have participated in the Ranji Trophy under different names. After independence, they played four seasons at Kathiawad before they became Saurashtra. However, what were they called till independence? A name that was made famous by a cricketer. Pan IIM, your time starts now.
Yeah, so this is Jamnagar, made famous by Ranjit Singh Ji, who was the Jam Sahib of Navanagar. So yeah, that's how the name Jamnagar came in, and that was the name pre-independence.
Trust a Gujju to get that.
Wait. No.
Oh. Okay. So.
No, so Jamnagar is the current name. Navanagar. My bad.
He was Jam Sahib of Navanagar, and that's how Jamnagar gets the name. Sorry.
No, I know, but you said Jamnagar. It was my bad. I had to kind of replace this. Sorry. I just scrapped this question. But to be fair to you, I know, team Pan IIM, I'll give you the next question. It was my bad. So, audience, you might have to sit out on this one because there's only one spare question we had to use up. My bad, guys. Sorry about that. Because right now it's called Jamnagar, so I also kind of jumped the gun there. Yeah, but it was Navanagar. I just realized when press page now. So, Pan IIM, the next question is to you. Hopefully, I don't make the same mistake twice. So, three aristocratic families of Bengal, eminent lawyer Bhupendranath Basu or Bhupendranath Bose and family, the Mitra family and the Sen family, got together on 15th August 1889 and started the first and earliest of its kind in India. It was based at the Marble Villa, I'll show a bigger picture in subsequent slide, in the Fariapukur Lane in North Calcutta, till the place proved small. It then relocated to larger facilities later on in the patronage of Maharaja Shampugur. You have to name the villa. I'll show you a bigger picture. So name this villa. Simple question. Pan IIM, your time starts now.
Mohan Bagan. The garden
of Mohan Bagan. Okay, I think I'll grant it to you. I don't want to be too pedantic. It's Mohan Bagan Villa. But it's Mohan Bagan Villa. That's fine. So yeah, I think you were in two words off. I think you were on the right track in the earlier question. It was my bad. So no harm, no foul. All right, Lucknow, next question comes to you. This is your direct. And this question is, okay. There's a visual now in the second, I'll come to that in a moment. There's a gentleman on the left who told to his wife as an explanation for his defeat in 1926. On the next slide, you'll also see a gentleman on the right who used the same excuse over 50 years later for a far more serious thing. So this again, you can get partial parts. You have to identify the gents that you see in the picture. And what was the excuse? What was the excuse that the gentleman told their wives? You see the gentleman on your screen now.
So the guy on the left made this excuse in 1926 to his wife, whom you see on his shoulders. And this was repeated more than 50 years later by the guy you see on the right for a more serious thing. Go back to the question.
Time starts now.
So this question is to IIM
Lucknow.
Direct question. Your time starts now.
Go back. Cheers.
Just show the visual ones, Rahul, they're asking. Yeah. Okay, back.
I am Calcutta. Questions? Oh, sorry, I am Lucknow.
Lucknow.
I am Calcutta.
So it's for Calcutta, right?
I am Lucknow. No, I am Lucknow. It was
Calcutta.
We have an answer.
We have an answer.
No, I am Lucknow. I am Lucknow. It was there direct. So I was supposed to let me ask them. Do they have an answer?
We and Ronald Reagan. I don't know what.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
Dewey and Ronald Reagan.
Dewey and Robert Ronald Reagan. Okay, I am Calcutta. The question passes to you now.
Yeah, the excuse was I should have dug. This was Ronald Reagan saying it to Nancy Reagan when he got shot.
Yeah.
And the other, the one on the left boxer. Was the boxer.
Boxer. Rocky Marciano.
I am Bangalore.
So the exact sentence was, honey, I forgot to duck. Gene Tunney said it in 1926 and then Ronald Reagan repeated it for the assassination attempt later.
Can you repeat the answer?
Gene Tunney.
He said Gene Tunney and Ronald Reagan, honey,
okay.
I forgot to duck. Pass it to?
Pass it to Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad, question passes to you.
So the guy said, honey, I forgot to duck. And the gentleman on the right is Ronald Reagan. The gentleman on the left is
John Lester.
Pan IIM, question passes to you.
Okay, we don't have anything to add. Like the other part, like honey, I forgot to duck and Ronald Reagan are our answers. Okay. So we don't know the
I think I'll give partial points to IIM Calcutta. It is indeed Honey, I Forgot to Duck, and it was said by Jack Dempsey, but he lost to Gene Tunney. I mean, someone answered Gene Tunney as the answer, but that was after his loss to Gene Tunney. So, IIM-C, you get 5 points for this. And next question.
Five for
Honey, I Forgot to Duck and Ronald Reagan. So, Jack Dempsey, you will have to get it. To get
basically, Jack Dempsey plus Reagan would have fetched you 5 points. No half of five for getting only one. So, no, not giving you 2.5 points. Five is the minimum currency we are dealing. Okay. Question now to IIM-B.
So, IIM-B, next question passes to, it's a visual, so, and it's a video. So, please listen carefully because it's a painful time to repeat it, you know, to play it again. So, I'll repeat, just say the question, play the videos, but don't ask for the replay because it gets a bit messy. So, please watch the videos carefully. So the first video is from the 1977 Wimbledon quarterfinal, and second 4 years later from 1981. You have to identify the two players, but that's not the real question. You have to identify in which common way did this incident associate themselves with what they said in the closely. So they say something in the videos, pay attention to it, and you identify what's the common thread. So I'm going to play the videos now. There are two videos. Please listen carefully. There are not going to be any replays for this one.
Stasi, will you please come this side of the court? There is a second service.
First of all, Stasi, you don't call me Stasi. You call me Mr. Stasi. That's better. Yes? Yes, sir. Yes? But I'm reporting you to referee. You call me Stasi. Call me Mr.
Okay, and now I'll play the second video. So obviously the players don't say their name, so there's not identifying players, that's not the question. They say something in the videos which kind of brings a common thread between the two. You have to identify in what common way they associate themselves closely. This was a direct question for
I am Bangalore.
This is your direct.
Elin Astase and John McEnroe. So they use their title, their autobiographies after what they just said. So you cannot be serious. And I guess Nastase was call me Mr. or something like that.
Yeah, I'll get into it as indeed. I'm actually surprised you got this. It's a very difficult one, but obviously, you've seen people tennis buff. Indeed, it was McEnroe and Nastase. and the outburst on the court became the titles of the autobiographies. Rai also tells me the practice of adding Mr. to address a player started after that incident with Nastase. Till then, it was not really a part of protocol. So it's indeed you cannot be serious, and Mr. Nastase, the name of the autobiography. So IIM-B, you get full points for that. IIM-A, the next question. Yeah, next question comes to you. All the best. When Louis Mayer, the first three-time winner, won his second Indy in 1933, he was hot and tired. So what unusual request did he make in the winner's lane?
This is the winner of the Indy 500 in Indianapolis.
So we'll play the Joker on this one.
Okay.
So he asked for a cold glass of milk, which gives the ritual of having milk on the winner's podium.
Yeah, I'll grant it to you. It was actually buttermilk, but I think milk is close enough. Indeed, he asked for a glass of buttermilk, his favorite drink, and thus starting the tradition for the winner of the Indy 500, which is the most acknowledged, most prestigious racing road race in the US, for drinking milk at the podium. Good one, IIM-A. I think you played your Joker. So, right, I played your Joker. You might want to So I think that was the last question for the teams. Next question is for the audience. So teams, please go on mute. Next question is for the audience.
I think there should be one more, isn't it?
Oh, no, sorry. Audience, I goofed up the first one. You're right. I goofed up the first one, the Jamnagar, Navanagar thing. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. So next question goes to Pan IIM. This is your direct. So audience, my apologies. No question for you this round. But you might actually have gotten lucky as well. Pan IIM, this is your direct. Pictured here is a Browning Ball M33 ammunition belt. Every fifth tip, pointed by the green arrows that you can see, has an orange tip. Every fifth bullet, sorry. So these bullets enable shooter to make aiming corrections because and obviate the need to use weapon sight. They can also be used to signal to other shooters where to focus their shooting during firing. What are they called? And it has a tangential connection to an Indian cricketer. If you get one, you will get the other. But what are they actually called?
Yeah, hi.
Pan IIM, this is your direct.
Okay, so we have the answer. So the orange tip.
What are they called?
Yeah, so tracer bullet. So they are called tracer bullet.
That's it.
Yeah.
All right, you have the connection for full points because.
Yeah, and that is Ravi Shastri uses that went like a tracer bullet in
yeah.
His
okay, fine. Fair enough. I will grant it to you. I think in a way it's divine justice because it was your question I goofed up. It comes back to you. So yeah, it's indeed tracer bullets with a small pyrotechnic charge, which makes the, they can see the path trace, which kind of makes it very visible. You can see that on the picture. So that finishes the sports round. Rai, you want to kind of update the scores?
Rahul, I just need you to go back through these questions because I seem to have missed giving points for one question. If you can just start back from question number 20. Oh, okay. I think it was moved one, so it should be 26 onwards. Okay, I'll correct it. Just give me a second.
All right, so fine. So that finishes round 5. And while Rai is updating the scores, the next round is hopefully the fun round. It's on the entertainment and a lot of video questions for that as well. So, guys, just a request, video questions are difficult for me to play back. They may or may not always work. So, please don't ask me to replay the videos. I'll let
so
you
know. I have the scores.
All right, so Rai, you want to update the scores?
The quiz is getting closer now with. I am Bangalore at 75, but Pan IIM with, one. Okay, so 75 for I am Bangalore, 60 for Pan IIM, 55 for I am Calcutta, 45 for Lucknow, and 45 for Ahmedabad. So Ahmedabad is now within hitting distance, but they need to have another good round.
All right. So here's the entertainment round, round 6, and a lot of videos. So audience, you can have your fill here. Question 1.
To IIM Lucknow.
Yeah, sorry. Thanks, bro. To IIM Lucknow? No, to IIM Lucknow. That's right. So the poet Girija Kumar Mathur worked for the All India Radio and Doordarshan and also won the Sahitya Academy Award in 1991. However, that's not the reason most people should be familiar with him. Indirectly familiar with him for translation of a famous anthem in the 70s when he was working with Doordarshan. Which song is this? Or which and translation of the anthem, which song did he translate? Give the English or Hindi, whichever one. The original English that he translated or the Hindi translated title. I am Lucknow. Your time starts now.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Is it we shall overcome?
Yeah, good guess. I am Agnaw. Indeed, we shall overcome. Hum honge kamyab. 10 points to you.
I think they are saying the same for this quiz as well.
Right. Hopefully, that's your answer for this quiz as well. Next question goes to IIM Calcutta. This is your direct. This one is a visual, not a video, but a visual. So in Kabhi Kabhi, the visual is on the next slide, during Rakhi's Kanyadan scene, there's a couple who was present on the sets, which was asked to basically step in the last minutes to play Rakhi's parents. You'll see in the next snap. Here to identify the couple. I am Calcutta, your time starts now.
Yeah, we can answer now.
Yeah.
Is it Harivansh Rai Bachchan and Tejinder Bachchan?
Yeah, good guess. If you're guessing, I am Calcutta. There's indeed the Harivansh Rai and Teji Bachchan who just happened to be on the sets, and they were asked to double up, you know, to step in as kind of supporting actors for that scene. Good guess. I am Bangalore. The next question is to you. This is a video one. So please listen carefully, all teams. It's difficult for me to replay this. So the video comes soon, but there's a J.G. Barrett who wrote the short story. He's written quite a few controversial stories, but one of the stories he wrote was The Sound Sweep, in which a deaf and dumb character goes around vacuuming up stray music in a world that has none. So while doing so, he comes across an opera singer hiding in a sewer. Now, this story was the inspiration behind a new wave song. You have to identify the song. Which song did this inspire? Sorry, there's no video. The answer is the video. So I can't be playing the answer, obviously. So you have to tell me which is this new way song that was inspired by this story. This was for I Am Bangalore, right? Yeah, I Am Bangalore. Your time starts now. This song is known in India as well for other reasons. So that's one more additional clue I can give all the teams.
You can say that it was remade into a Hindi song.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, that's all I can say. I can't give you more than that.
Clues, so, yeah. Too many clues. Don't give.
Okay. IIM-C looks like they have the answer.
Yeah, I think time should be up.
So, right. Anand, is it time?
Yep.
Yeah. I am Bangalore. You have the answer?
No, we don't.
Mac the knife.
Okay, question passes to I am Ahmedabad. I am Ahmedabad, you have the answer? Your time starts now. All right, your time's up. Your question passes to Pan IIM.
Is it
Makarena? Question passes to I am Lucknow.
Okay, so I'll give half of it. So it's Deepesh Mode. The song is Break the Silence, Enjoy the Silence. It's the silence something. It's a Deepesh Mode song.
Question passes to I am Calcutta. Here's a chance to show your bravado.
You have to sing the answer.
Yeah.
It's Hoobas Tank.
No, sorry. Not even close. So I'll open the question up to the audience. Let me see if anyone in the audience has got the answer. You have to tell which song was... TG, Krishnamurti, you got really the answer correct. TG Krishnamurti got the answer right. It's Video Kill the Radio Star.
I
definitely the first song ever played on MTV.
Yes.
Okay, so that was actually also in the, it's quite a philosophical song. So the song was done in the advent of Kraftwerk, which is a techno band. And there was a fear that, you know, computers will start generating songs and killing the real creative singers at all. A very deep philosophy, which was very aptly captured by Bappi Lahiri when he wrote, Koi aha nache nache, awwa awwa. I mean, with two awwas, it's difficult to miss the pain.
And as one of the teams pointed out, this was the first song played when MTV.
Yeah. MTV, I didn't know that either. So I think Niloy said it. So next question goes to, I lost track now. Who was
so this was IIM Bangalore's direct who missed it. So it will now go to IIM Ahmedabad.
Okay, IIM Ahmedabad.
Hey, Rajiv, you said it comes back to the same team. That was
it comes back to the next team. The word back should have been removed, but it goes to the next team is what the rules say.
Wait. So IIM Ahmedabad, this is your direct, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm the. This is your direct. This one is a video one, so please watch the video carefully. So you have to. There's a scene there which has a car driver and a hero and the protagonist. You have to identify the car driver singing about death. Only other clue I can give is died in 1976, and the hero who's shown here sleeping in the car, he said when he passed away, "Meri jaan hi chali gayi." Again, it's the car driver. You have to identify the physical actor who's playing the car driver. The video starts now.
छोटी सी ये जिंदगानी रे चार दिन की जवानी तेरी आए रे हाय गम की कहानी तेरी छोटी सी ये जिंदगानी रे चार दिन की जवानी तेरी आए रे हाय गम की कहानी तेरी.
Okay, I am in the bar. Your time starts now. Simple question. I need a name. Identify the car driver.
Yeah, the car driver is Mukesh and Raj Kapoor said that about him.
Yeah, very good. I mean, I guess that is a bit easier. Put 10 points to you. That is indeed Mukesh. That was the only acting thing I knew he has performed. Actually, I didn't know that either. I mean, Raj was right. But when you look back, the resemblance to Neem Rathin Mukesh is so obvious. It's a bit of a sitter. You got lucky, I guess. But everyone needs that a bit. Next question is to Pan IIM. This is again a video one. So please watch your videos carefully. So the name of this 2006 film denotes the Sufi concept of dying before one dies. But that's not the, you don't have to identify the film. That's not the question. The question is, where is this song shot? It was the only time this permission was granted for this location. Pan IIM, your time starts up soon as the song ends. The song starts now. Right. So, Pan IIM, you have to identify the location where this song was shot. So, the video is a bit long for you to absorb the location. Your time starts now.
Okay, when you say location, is it the city or?
No.
Specific location within a city.
Specific location.
Okay, we are guessing, is it Humayun's tomb?
Question passes to IIM Lucknow.
What did they say?
They said Humayun's tomb.
Hazrat Bal is our response.
Question passes to IIM Calcutta.
Is it the Dargah at Ajmer? I think Chisti or something. The
Mainuddin Chisti is Dargah.
Dargah at Ajmer.
Question passes to IIM Bangalore.
We go with the Blue Mosque in Istanbul.
No, I guess, but I can see why you guessed that. Question passes to IIM-A. If not, it will go to the audience. Audience, don't type in yet. Question is not really open to you.
We think Hagia Sophia?
No, audience, the question is open to you. Yeah, Tarun Nallu. Chitkala. Chitkala gets it right. It is indeed Rashtrapati Bhavan. That's where the song was shot. The only time the permission was granted for only movie ever to be shot in Rashtrapati Bhavan. So Chitkala gets it right from the audience. And we come back now to the next question, which is anyway for the audience. Audience, next question is for you. This is also a video.
I think the audience is thrashing the teams. Yeah.
Yeah, good thing we didn't ask them to form a team. So the next one is a video, and there's you have to identify who played the role of the dentist, Dr. Team Wesley from 94-90. Not the patient, he's obvious. You have to identify the dentist in the video. He was nominated for an Oscar, but he truly shone to light in his moment of sun or popularity came from the period 2008 to 2013. The video starts now.
Where's Jennifer today?
Oh, she's over at Dr. Sussman's office. Yeah, we find it fun to swap now and then. You just take some deep breaths and try to relax.
All right, audience, I need the name of the dentist, the actor. Okay, quite a few people got this right. The first one is Pranjal Agarwal. It's indeed Bryan Cranston or Walter White or Heisenberg from the movie from the show Breaking Bad. Pranjal Agarwal, you got it right. And that finishes round six. Two more rounds to go. We are doing well for time. So still half an hour left. We should be finishing on time as well. For those who had plans for the rest of the evening. So Rai, you want to update scores? We go on to the next round.
Okay, Bangalore continues to be in the lead. Their lead has been whittled down a bit now. Calcutta at 65, Pan IIM at 60, and Ahmedabad and Lucknow jostling just close by at 55.
All right. So two rounds to go, entering the home stretch. Next round is science, nature, and exploration. And the question... This is the part which I never...
The last question was for Pan IIM, so therefore now it should be for... Lucknow.
So Lucknow, this is your direct question. Science, nature, and exploration. Your question is, so comets are among the most, you know, spectacular objects we can witness over the naked eye and have been written about and tracked for nearly a millennium and more. But there's a very interesting observation made by German scientist Ludwig Biermann and by another German scientist called Paul Arnert in the 1950s. What was this observation that was made by them? I am Lucknow. Your time starts now.
It's about the tail, which is made of ice particles, not fire, as earlier believed.
So you're saying the observation is that the tail is made of ice particles?
Yeah, you pass it.
Okay. Pass this to I am Calcutta.
What? Very interesting.
Yeah. So that the tail always points away from the sun.
Yes, I'll grant it to you. I'm Calcutta. That is indeed the answer. The bright tail of iron disk always points away from the sun, and that helps them calibrate and project the paths of the comets much more accurately. That's indeed the answer. IIM-C, well done. Next question goes to IIM
Bangalore.
A bit long-winded. The Central Camera Company of Chicago, this is had in 1936 for the revolutionary Keystone camera. Or what was the revolutionary natural color movie camera. The advertising line or the promotional line in the marketing collateral was, all you do is sight your subject to the telescopic finder and press the automatic button. That's all that is there to it. /++++++. They ended up creating a 7-word catchphrase, which was later on adopted by the IT industry. So what was that 7-word catchphrase? I am Bangalore, your time starts now.
This is what you see is what you get, YCV. Wow.
Yeah, that was a bit too far. That is indeed the answer. What you see is what you get, also known as Visivik, later offered by WordStar, and then, of course, you know, became a common terminology. I am Bangalore, full points to you. Next question goes to I am Ahmedabad. This is your direct. So the desert elephants of Mali, they migrate almost 500 kilometers a year, sometimes as much as, you know, more than 55 kilometers in a day, all for pursuing water. And they are usually a very stubby, short tusk, which led to the speculation that they are suffering from dietary deficiency or, you know, even the water deficiency. But honestly, they are otherwise actually healthy and even reproduce successfully. Subsequently, what was the most likely and widely accepted the reason for their small, stubby tusks?
The visual.
This is the visual. As you can see, their tusks are very small. So I need the reason behind the short, stubby tusks.
Time starts now.
Your time starts now. Yes. Thanks, Anand.
I'm Ahmedabad.
Can you go back to the questions?
So we think.
Yeah, I mean, you can answer.
Yeah, so we think the elephants in Mali were poached, have been poached for the longest time. So just by natural selection, the ones with the biggest tusks have been whittled down and the genetics.
Yep, I will grant it to you. You said the key word, but anyway, natural selection. That was in the answer. Poachers for so many animals that basically the natural selection took over and, you know, left individuals only whose tusks are not worth harvesting, kind of the nature's way of poaching defense. All right, good answer, IIM-A. The next question goes to Pan IIM. This is your direct question. All the best. The electric rays, eels, stun prey by discharging, you know, electric charge of between 8 to 220 volts. Anyone who handles or, you know, missteps or mishandles on a living electric ray can really get badly numb. So obviously, at all species, there are genus and the species, but I need the genus name, which was later used as also the name of a weapon. So, Pan IIM, your time starts now.
Yeah, taser.
Sorry, what is it?
Taser.
Okay, question passes to IIM Lucknow.
Did you show the visual? Anyway, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, I mean, you're right. There's a visual, but if it helps.
It doesn't matter, really.
Yeah, in this question,
go, go back to the question.
I'm Lucknow, your time's up. You have the answer?
Go back to the question, Rahul.
Question passes to I'm Calcutta.
Stun guns are the name of the weapon. I don't know.
Boy, really fishing, shooting in the dark. Okay, I am Bangalore.
Torpedo.
Brilliant. Yes, indeed. The genus is called torpedo. You know, I thought most people might end up guessing stinger or something. But yeah, torpedo is indeed the answer. Torpedo is the genus name. Great answer, I am Bangalore. Next question and the last one in the round for the teams goes to I am Ahmedabad. I mean, your time to catch up. Not too many shots left now. IIM-A, this is your direct. This was a press release just last month by the CEO of an American company. I don't want to read out the entire kind of press release. You can kind of read it up. Simple question, which company's CEO was this? I need the name of the full company. It's workoutable, but I leave it to your judgment.
Time starts now.
Yeah, sorry, your time starts now. Thanks, Anand.
I think give them 10 more seconds to read.
Fair enough. Anand, just give them maybe 40 seconds in this one because the press statement is a bit longish.
Yeah, thank you.
So I think that was a 30-second timer. I'll just wait. Or was that the 40-second?
40 seconds.
Okay. All right, IIM-A, your time's up. Which company CEO was this? You have an answer?
Raytheon.
Question passes to Pan IIM.
Delta Airlines.
Extremely excellent answer. It was indeed a Delta Airlines. He avoided the word Delta variant because he associated the variant with the airline. So he used the word B1617.2. So he did not want any association with the virus. A bit of a weird way of trying to put some distance between you and a negative PR. But great guess, Pan IIM. Worked out very well. All right. So that was the last question for the team. Next question is for the audience. So audience, I think this one is going to be a bit extremely fast. So the one, there's going to be a picture and you have to identify the location. Which location is this? There are enough clues in the picture for you to guess. I Let me see the Q&A. Ah, okay. The first one is, again, Pranjal Agarwal. Yes, indeed, it is Pokhran. Those three milestones signifying the three dates. And of course, you can see the structure of the atom back there signifying some horribly done quiche art. But yeah, that's indeed Pokhran. Pranjal Agarwal gets it. So that finishes round, the penultimate round, round seven. Rai, you want to give a scores update?
So I'm Bangalore, did very well in the science round as was to be expected. Swami and their team is an expert in these matters. So they are on 95. Calcutta at 75 in the second place. Pan IIM closely following them with 70. And Ahmedabad at 65. Lucknow at 55. So the first place, I think barring a miracle, is being decided. But the second and third places are up for grabs.
All right. You never know. Miracles happen. As we enter the last round, let's see where do we end up at.
This is for the Lucknow.
Last round. Okay, Lucknow. So we start with you. This is an art and architecture, and your first question, the direct question, is this also a bit of a longish question. So the earliest extant text that one which still exists to mention this legend is the 16th century Katha Kalpatan. The local king of this place suffered from a severe disease. His queen prayed to Shiva at Alapura to cure her husband. She vowed to construct a temple, and if her wish was granted, promised to observe a fast until she could see the shikhar of the top of the temple. So the king was cured. She started fasting, and temple had to be built immediately. But almost everyone said it's going to take months to build one. And she obviously, if she fast, she will die. But Kokasa, the architect, assured that he could do what was required in a week and thus save the queen's life. Which temple are we talking about? But for full points on the real answer, what you want is how did Kokasa manage it? I am Lucknow. Your time starts now.
So, is it the Kedarnath thing where they just built the temple on the peak?
Question passes to IIM Calcutta.
Sure. Is it the Pashupati temple in Kathmandu, and it was by putting this what do you call
shikara
it? Shikara first. So it was built like top down.
Question passes to IIM Bangalore.
So he built the structure top down. I think it's the Kailashnath temple at Ellora.
Yeah, I'll give it to you. I am Bangalore. Extremely good. The whole structure was carved up from a single piece of gigantic piece of rock, and it was carved from top down, starting with the shikhar first. So it got completed in a week. No one knows exactly how long it took, but it's a brilliant piece of architecture when you realize it was done more than 1200 years back and was carved from top down, and it's extremely intricate. For those of you who have not been there, the Ajanta Ellora caves, you know, in eastern Maharashtra. Well done, IIM-B. I think you kind of put even more distance between
you and
the next.
We get 5 points for the second part, right? We get 5 for the second.
You get 5 points for hoping, but I can't give you points for the answer.
So the concept of taking a rock and viewing it from the top, you did not really explain it.
Yeah.
So
I have to give it to IIM Bangalore. Next question goes to IIM Ahmedabad. You see a sculpture on your slide, on your screen. It's called Camille Claudel's Lavague. It's a cover version of what artists call when they, you know, repeat work of another artist, or another work of art, which replaces the humans in the original with sea nymphs that you see on the screen. So look carefully at the sculpture and name the original famous work of art, which was also made famous, I think, about 60-70 years earlier in the 1830s. So I need the original work of art, which was kind of this sculpture thing you're paying a tribute to. IIM-A, your time starts now.
Is this a piece from Rodin's Gates of Hell?
Question passes to Pan IIM.
Rodin is a thinker.
Question passes to IIM Lucknow.
There's no humans in that.
particular. That was my original answer when I saw this.
Pan, I'm going to go on mute. I am Lucknow. You have an answer?
Venus.
Question passes to IIM Calcutta.
Yeah, so this is Hokusai's, the Japanese painting, The Waves of Kanagawa.
Very good, very good. It is indeed the gateway of Kanagawa Hokusai. You can see that in the background also in my speech. That's indeed the, which was painted by Hokusai in the 1850s or 1830s, kind of signify the imminent threat of the American force opening on future of Japan. Great answer, IIM Calcutta. Next question goes to IIM Bangalore. This one's a direct. So we are talking about the structure. It was one of the first structures involving the use of computers in the structural analysis to understand the force distribution. The project itself was delayed repeatedly, and when finished, it was widely condemned as ugly, though it's a reputation that has been kind of restored today. So you identify the structure which came up at the location, which you'll see shortly. It's a sketch. So I need the name of which structure are we talking about. And the location in the sketch is what you see on your screen right now.
Where that hut you can see in the center of the visual is where this structure is.
It should be Sydney Harbour and the Sydney Opera House.
Actually, I don't know why I even doubted you would not get it. It's indeed the Sydney Opera House. Made by a Danish architect. It was widely condemned. It's several budget overruns. I think a 5-year project went completed in 14 years, but today it's one of the most iconic structures in the Southern Hemisphere. Great answer, IIM Bangalore. Next question is to IIM-A. This is your direct. So this set of seven designed in 2002 was chosen to illustrate, classical antiquity, Roman period, different periods of basically architecture. This set needed to serve 19 entities. They were completely fictional to avoid any favoritism. So the Dutch designer Robin Stam decided to make them real because they're actually fictitious, but kind of the designer decided to make them real and for use by pedestrians and cyclists, and were built to look exactly like the fictional creations. Which set of seven is this? I mean, apart from the physical bridges that you see, where else would you see this seven? Set of seven?
So out of the seven, three we are showing it to you here. There are seven of them, but three reproductions are shown.
Thanks, Hasna.
This is a direct question to IIM Ahmedabad, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Your time starts now. Sorry, I forgot to mention that.
Our question, right?
Is it Ahmedabad?
Yeah, it's Ahmedabad.
Yes.
Are these the seven bridges on Königsberg?
Good guess, but no. Question passes to IIM, sorry, the Pan IIM team. Your time starts now. Pan IIM, you have an answer?
Yeah, we pass.
IIM Lucknow.
Is it
to reference real life history? So I am Lucknow. It's a bit too noisy. Can one of you answer? What's your answer?
Seven deadly sins.
They
are saying seven deadly sins. They are nowhere near.
No. Okay, fine. Question passes to IIM Calcutta.
This is Amsterdam, but what set?
We don't know. Sorry, pass.
Question pass to IIM Bangalore.
It's the Euro banknote. So these are bridges on the Euro.
Yes, bank. It's indeed the Euro banknote. So the bridges didn't exist. They were created later on, to signify the bridges to check. Which is a brilliant answer, IIM Bangalore.
Yeah.
That was honestly extremely difficult, just guess it. Brilliant answer. And the actual what right has been actual physical spots from there where you could look at it, so the bridge looks exactly the same it appears on the Euro banknote. Brilliant answer. Which brings us to the last question, which goes to IIM-A. This is your direct last question. I think we know the winners already, but let's complete the formalities. IIM-A, your last question. In 1962, Jackie Kennedy met the French culture minister André Malraux and charmed him to agreeing to this. this specific event. The rest of the establishment shocked, threatened resignation, went ahead anyways, but there are riots in Paris and De Gaulle imposed a media blackout to keep it the event low-key. The Coast Guard got involved, traffic was brought to a standstill, and it's the only time it's ever happened. Finally, it was all worth it. What event are we talking about? IIM-A, your time starts now. I may your answer, your time's up.
So it's to do with the shifting of the Statue of Liberty.
Question passes to Pan IIM.
It was like putting up the French flag on Statue of Liberty.
Question passes to IIM Lucknow.
So this was about displaying Mona Lisa in a museum in New York.
Yeah, I'll grant it to you. Indeed, Mona Lisa coming to US. The first time it happened, a huge event with obviously controversial influence for the obvious reasons. So IIM Lucknow, you get 10 points. We have a question for the audience. So Rai, just wait till we complete the audience question. You can announce the winner.
Okay.
Audience, next question is for you. A certain location was originally named for a member of this British royal family and the Governor General of Canada, but was renamed for a mother-son pair in 1995. Which location are we talking about? Let me check the answers. Victoria Albert Museum. Good guess, but no. Okay, I'll have to start my countdown. This looks like a difficult one. Teams, you might want to take a shot at it because there are not too many answers coming from the audience. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Teams, you have to have a shot at it.
Yeah, so this was Connaught Place renamed as Rajeshwari.
Correct. That's right. It's indeed Connaught Place. I have no points for this, but great answer. Indeed Connaught Place. And that brings us to the end of this quiz. And Rai, do we have a winner?
We have a winner for sure.
Rai, Rajiv, before you go into that, I think we just wanted to do something from a Pan IIM perspective. Could we take a few minutes?
Okay.
Thank you. First of all, everyone, thank you very much for participating. And before Rajiv announces the winners and the order of the thing, I just wanted to say that, you know, while this is a competitive and, like you said, somewhat a little bit, sometimes we get tribal about these things. There was a brilliant initiative about a few months ago in which the entire IIM alumni community, not just here, but in other countries, as well as other alumni communities, came together to do something that was really remarkable. And that is the Breathe Life Initiative. And Deepika will just play you. We just did a short video, and I think everybody knows what happened in that, but we just play a short video, which I think celebrates what the Pan IIM alumni community came together across institutes and batches to do. Over to you, Deepika, to just share that video before we announce the results.
So I'll just pause share. So Deepika, you can take it.
Rahul,
I'll stop here.
The sound is already enabled at your end. I don't know whether the system sound is enabled at my end. I've shared it with you as a link as well. If you can share it, it's by WhatsApp. I've just sent you the link. You can share it. Otherwise, I will play it.
All right. Let me just... let me see if I can get it right. Okay. Is this the Pima Breathe Life campaign? That's the one?
Yep, That's the one.
Okay. Just let me sort it out first.
And meanwhile, while Rahul pulls it up, just want to thank Rajiv, especially for coming together every year and putting this wonderful quiz together. Like I said, this year, I thought we got a lot more answers than we did. So next year, Rajiv, we look forward to your upping the game again and making sure that only 50% get answered or whatever. Okay, over to back to you, Rahul. Thank you.
All right, I'm playing the video right now. So hopefully, you can hear the sound as well. Okay.
India's death toll crisis in India is intensifying. Other hospitals say they have just hours left of supplies.
And in Singapore, IIM alumni watched in distress, except they refused to be onlookers.
We got on a call and we said, we can't just stand by and watch helplessly. We had to do something. But we'd never done anything like this before.
Within just 2 days, the Breathe Life into India campaign was born. Fast forward to just 6 weeks later, June 15th, over 2,150 oxygen concentrators, 16,000 plus cylinders, and over 13 oxygen plants were successfully delivered across India. This is a story of snowballing collaboration across IIM alumni Singapore, tapping the power of their network, using their expertise as business leaders, bringing groups together, pooling resources and skills quickly.
The whole team swung into action mode. We started making calls inside and outside the community. The High Commissioner of India, senior leaders in DBS and Temasek, the Red Cross. We reached out to volunteers from other alumni associations and to our very own service-minded alumni community. The response? Phenomenal.
The team put their management training to work at breakneck speed through their busy day jobs and sleepless nights. There was no slowing them down.
Looking back, it was like day zero of a startup, figuring out supply chains, raising money, avoiding last mile hiccups. Anything could go wrong.
We submitted our application on an emergency basis to cut short the 6 week timeline. The MCCY responded with a counter proposal. Why not work with the Singapore Red Cross? They already had all approvals in place for India COVID relief.
While it was time critical for us to get our campaign started, it was equally important for us to ensure that all things that we did were within the spirit and letter of the law. I worked closely with the partners to ensure that funds received from our large corporates were channeled properly and any CSR requirements were met. At the same time, I had to work with the partners to ensure they gave us visibility to how funds received were being used, both in terms of actual deployment as well as procurement of equipment. And that allowed us to not only get back to our owners, but also meet our Singapore audit requirements.
A Filipino friend designed our beautiful logo. The children of alumni got involved to create content. And we had other people from the network get us coverage in Straits Times and CNBC. And this steady communication really kept the donations coming.
The campaign opened on 1st of May. Within 78 hours, it hit the $1 million Singapore dollars mark.
I met the team. They were very, very passionate about what they were doing. And they want to make sure the sourcing part and the delivering to the person who needs it, which is what any person with money requires when they're donating to make sure the money is put to good use. So I committed from my own side, and then I could reach out to people with money to also donate similar amounts and larger amounts. And I was very moved by the fact that these guys opened not only their wallets but their hearts. They asked what else they could help, and the money poured in, and we could finally do what we could helping.
But that was just the start. The Herculean task ahead was to deploy the funds so help reached where needed.
The money was pouring in and we had to act fast to find supplies. Through our alumni network in Taiwan, in China, in the Middle East, and through the sheer persistence of the volunteer team, we were able to quickly identify a set of reputed, qualified suppliers. These suppliers would meet WHO standards for a variety of supplies such as concentrators, cylinders, PSA plants, and medical equipment. The challenge didn't end there. We had to then work with these suppliers to ensure that they met delivery schedules, managing the volatility of raw materials and other supplies. And then we had to work closely and follow up on a day-to-day basis in order to ensure that the equipment was shipped, it reached India, and working with the last mile partners, ensure it was delivered at the end.
In the beginning, it was very exhausting. First 3 weeks were tough.
We had a team of, we scaled up a team to 20 volunteers across India and Southeast Asia. And the team was, doing work end-to-end, identifying suppliers, doing the supplier vetting, handling logistics, all the paperwork required as well to get the products into India. We did quite a bit of work with a lot of donor efforts and state governments as well, a lot of diversity there. It was good to work with across different foundations.
Rahul, you are kind of stalling.
Oxygen generators due from Turkey.
Yes, sorry.
In spite of the tireless hours which had been spent in researching, we were all very skeptical given the fact that we were new to learn about this industry, and also we did not know the vendor. When the consignment arrived, it came with...
You need to put it on full screen.
Sorry, I didn't realize I was sharing. I think I kind of messed it up.
Forthcoming and willing to help. It's been a great initiative with everybody coming together for a common good.
By mid-June, the team's WhatsApp groups were going abuzz with pictures of delivered consignments and thank you notes. Their month-long efforts were finally nearing fruition. It's amazing what's been achieved. Over 2 million Singapore dollars of donations collected. 6 million Singapore dollars worth of supplies enabled.
I was reminded of the story of the bumblebee that my first boss told me. According to the laws of aerodynamics, the bumblebee, with its tiny wings, has no chance of lifting off the ground. Mission impossible. But it does not know that and does it anyway. The Breathe Life mission for me was the proverbial bumblebee.
At least 100,000 lives will be impacted this year from what we did.
Breathe Life name is such an evocative name. It didn't just breathe life into India. I think it breathed life into all of us alumni and made us feel really good about having accomplished something amazing.
We've run high-impact events before to showcase business leadership. But Breathe Life is real impact, real leadership on the ground. Any one of us can make a difference. All of us together can make a much bigger difference. I'm proud to be an IIM alumnus. Let's harness this spirit to be a force for greater good in Singapore, in India, and for the world.
Thank you for that, Rahul, and thank you, everyone. It's not just, I think, the alphabets. I just wanted to say that I think this is one thing where we all came together as a bunch of alumni across institutes, and it was such a fantastic thing to be part of and to be proud of as to what we can achieve. But meanwhile, I think it's back to being an alphabet and a little bit of tribalism before we close for the day. So back to you, Rahul and Rajiv. Once again, Rahul, thank you. As always, you're a brilliant quiz master, Rajiv, for putting this together. Back to the two of you.
And before Rajiv kind of says, can I request the Pan IIM, IIM-C and Pan to open their videos so that I can take some pictures while he's talking so we can get a snapshot? Perfect. Oh. Rajiv, over to you.
Oh. The whole team left. That was from the video.
Well, at least you show yourself. Okay, smile, guys. Thanks.
All right, Rai, over to you. Pronounce the winner.
Okay, so now the alphabet soup. Finishing joint fourth are the teams from IIM Ahmedabad and Lucknow. And in the third place, we had the Pan IIM team, which beat some of their alma maters in their combined team. And they were third. The second was IIM Calcutta, which put up an impressive performance and did well towards the end as well. They got 85 points. But winning the quiz with a very defining and authoritative performance, backed by some really nice answers, was IIM Bangalore team, 125 points. They make up for their disappointment last year. And I'm sure they will be a force to come in the next year as well.